The PIBatch database architecture is tightly integrated with the PI server architecture. It was introduced in PI server version 3.3, and it is considered part of the module database structure that we have in the PI server. And the PIBatch database allows us to gather and archive real-time data in time frames, and we have defined certain parameters in the PIBatch database. For example, the campaign, batch, unit batch, and subbatch layers. Although, as we'll see a little bit later in the class, our current batch generator will only use batch, unit batch, and subbatch layers. We have not implemented the campaign layer of the PIBatch database. There's also something called the transfer record database as well, and it is currently not implemented in our batch generator interface. It may be used by other applications. We give you a nice graphical configuration tool with the PI system management tools, and so you can use our tools to view the data, or you can develop your own. We provide complete read-write access to the batch database using our PI SDK. This is a diagram that you'll see throughout this course, and it's just here to illustrate how tightly woven all of the systems are, all of the architectures are with one another in the PIBatch database with regard to the PI system. And you can see here that this piece is representing our PI archive. This supplies all process values, and it's actually where we store the event frame batch information. The PIBatch database stores batch records, so the PI archive stores specific information about each batch, whereas the PIBatch database stores the record itself. This diagram represents the PIBatch database from an architectural or hierarchical standpoint. At the top, we have the PICampaign level. The PICampaign is made up of one or more PIBatches. A PIBatch is constructed of one or more PIUnitBatch structures. And the PIUnitBatch can be made up of one or more subbatches. Subbatches can in turn have other subbatches. Let's take a look at each one of these in sequence. The PICampaign is the highest level in the batch database hierarchy. It's the name of a campaign. Usually it's the product that's being made, and it has a specific start and end time. We have the PIBatch layer, which is the second level of the PIBatch database hierarchy, and the PIBatch contains the names of products and batches. It usually references some sort of recipe, and normally a batch, PIBatch, will have a specific start and end time. Sometimes these might be considered lots. And there's some other data that we store along with that. The PIUnitBatch is actually the unit or units that are actually producing the materials, whereas the PIBatch level was a lot or run of a product. The UnitBatch is actually where the production is taking place. And it usually contains the name of the unit and the batch, UnitBatch ID. Occasionally, we would include the product or the recipe name, and of course, start and end times. And then the golden batch rule, which says only one unit batch may be active in a unit over any given time period. That's the PIBatch golden rule. We realize there are some production processes where a single unit might be running multiple batches at one time. However, the PIBatch database cannot accommodate that particular structure. Only one unit batch may be active in a unit at one time. Finally, we get to the subbatch level, and the subbatch level is usually where some step or some operation or phase is taking place within a unit batch. And the subbatches, they are optional. Again, they're usually operations or phases. And they will have start and end times that are within the start and end time of the unit batch. And subbatches can themselves have collections of subbatches. So the hierarchy is very rich.